whispered ramble in the dark here tonight. Just gonna ramble for maybe 10 to 15 minutes or something. I've been a little too heavy on the gum chewing. I think my last four videos are gum chewing, so hopefully my next two or three will be non-gum chewing videos, this being one. I wanted to do an eating video, but I ended up eating my popcorn earlier. Some of the games, like it's crazy, like the Final Fantasies are so much cheaper for the Super Famicom, and a big part of that is I would assume, at least for, you know, people buying in the USA or Europe or whatever, and pretty much anywhere else other than Japan, is that it's just heavy text and it's in Japanese, so unless you can read it, you're not gonna be able to really play it. I mean, maybe you could, but that's another thing I want to do. I kind of want to learn to read the kanji, the letters and stuff, over time maybe, and then I could pick up more games, like a lot of RPGs. But there are games that are English friendly or even have the option for English. It's not a ton, but like beat 'em ups and stuff, it's like, you know, if I don't know what the characters are saying, it's not gonna bother me as long as I can play the game. Like the final fights are cheaper on especially 2 and 3 are much or is it final fight, I don't know, it's, but 2 for sure I was looking at as well. The Seeker of Mana game, Seeker of Mana 2, and Trials of Mana on there. I think they're playable as well, even though there's more text. That's an action RPG, but beat 'em ups, the game I got shouldn't be an issue with the text either. And most of the menus on the games are in English. So, you know, as long as I can play the game, there's a lot of beat 'em ups for that system. There's exclusives that, you know, are also, you know, side scrollers or whatever that are playable that I'm interested in, and they're cheap. You know, even Link to the Past is like 50, you know, you can find it for 10, 15 cheaper. I mean, even complete games in box over there are a good amount cheaper. it's like gotten me really like, this is the most excited I've been about games in a while. And I'm like, I always like games and I'm excited, but there's like just another level of excitement as well. And how about some hand motions as well? Screw it. See myself going pretty decent with this collection. You know, some games are comparable in terms of, you know, USA and, you know, the Japanese versions, Super Famicom, Super Nintendo ones. Super Metroid is a game that's cheaper for the Super Famicom. I never played it, and supposedly it has an option to play in English as well, which would be awesome. There's, you know, games like Contra, The Alien Wars, or Super Castlevania 4, Super Ghouls and Ghosts is a little cheaper, but those two are kind of comparable, and some are even more expensive. It's funny, like, certain ones are more expensive for Super Famicom. I was looking at Super Back to the Future 2, which only came out over in Japan, but it's super expensive. but it's just an opportunity, you know, and it's just got me excited. I don't know, I might end up moving other games from my other systems. I consider doing that anyway, but maybe some of the dead weight, I don't, you know, games I know I'm not going to play, I might move, sell on eBay or whatever, I don't know. But yeah, you know, as of anything else, you know, with what's going on, I have my good and bad days. You know, I think everybody's starting to feel it, you know. I mean, that's not a unique thing to any one person, especially if you can work, if you can still go to work, you have a different kind of anxiety, obviously, especially if you're on the front lines of this thing. It's a different anxiety, and the people at home have a different anxiety. Except the people at home, typically, I mean, you still gotta go out and get food or whatever you gotta do. There's still things you have to go do, so you're still could be in contact with stuff. But the people on the front lines have to worry about, you know, obviously, you know, really, you know, getting sick. But being at home, you don't have to really worry about that if you're staying home as much as possible, but you get the cabin fever, you know, people kind of, you know, get the, you're just like, I mean, you can take some walks and stuff, but even that just doesn't, I don't know, but what are you gonna do? Like I said, hopefully, you know, that changes, but, you know, you just gotta wait and see what happens, I suppose. It's, you know, everybody's trying to hang in there the best they can. The show Unbelievable on Netflix was good. It was like 7 or 8 episodes. I think we watched it all in one day. So it was a little tiring, but it was like a dip of the Witcher. I've been watching Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated on there as well again. That's a great Scooby-Doo. It's hilarious. That's the best probably since the original in the 60s and early 70s. I talked about That's another thing I can do with these Super Famicom games as well, is kind of do, you know, come chewing gameplays and stuff. That'll be fun. The game I'm getting, I hope the battery, this game has a battery backup. I hope the battery is not dead. If it is, what are you going to do? Even the description, you know, says that, and I understand that. As long as it works, first things first, I want it to work, so then I can move forward with getting games for this thing. But it's just, like I said, it excites me or whatever. But doing a my friend's mom texted me the other day. Her daughter is turning 40 on the 1st of May, so we're going to do like a drive-by little parade past the house or whatever. And she's like, "Oh, you want to, you're interested?" I was like, "Yeah, sure, I'll go do that." So we'll do that and stuff, so we'll see how that goes. What else is there? And stuff, so it's probably related to that, I would guess. What else? Let's see. I've been tired. What else? It's Listen Liberal, or how like the Democrats pretty much sold out the working class. It's like infuriating, the stuff that happened, you know, for what's been going on for a long time now. But give that another read, or finish reading, I should say. But because it's actually really infuriating when you're reading it, like you're getting pissed at the stuff they've done, you know. He's actually more liberal leaning, but he will point out their flaws and stuff. He's one of those people, you know, I like people on either sides who can point out the flaws of their party, you know, and obviously not everybody, you know, you don't have to be, you can be independent, I guess, you know, as well. But enough of that. No need for that kind of talk, I suppose. But what else? Now the cat's getting up. She's going to start making a move, probably, or to get more dry food, maybe. But yeah, I guess I'll end this now, but just a bit of a